Drive, down. Rugby is what you would call a full contact sport.
Drive, down.
At San Diego State, members of the rugby team go through a series of brutal drills to get ready for the fall season. And if you think this is rough, you should see a game where practically anything goes. Training and conditioning coach Oren Cotret has played semi-pro rugby for years. In the heat of battle, he's gotten his front teeth knocked out and torn up his knee, not to mention numerous lacerations. And concussions? Don't ask.
Well, you definitely get a little dizzy, see some stars sometimes depending on the severity of it.
But Cotret says even when a player suffers a concussion, he usually wants to keep on playing.
This is one of the sports where we actually thrive on actually being very competitive, being very physical, and nobody wants to come out of a game in this kind of sport.
So if you get your head knocked around a little bit, you get dizzy, so what?
Right? Yeah, shake it off, get back up.
But here's the problem. If a player goes back in too soon, they're at higher risk of getting a secondary concussion, and that can cause irreparable brain damage. In the biomechanics lab at San Diego State, Professor Daniel Goebel tests his new device called B-Trax. It's designed to precisely measure an athlete's ability to maintain proper balance. Balance is one of the things that's affected when a person suffers a concussion.
The green line is a representation of his sway. So if he moves right, the line goes right. If he moves left, and so it's just tracking how much he sways. And we know that the more you sway, the worse your balance is.
On the sidelines of college and pro sports, athletic trainers do an assessment of players they suspect of suffering a concussion. They ask some questions, observe their behavior, and measure their balance. But the balance tests are highly subjective. Two trainers can come up with completely different results. One might keep a player off the field, while the other might let them go back in.
So what we wanted to do was create something that was objective. It took the trainer out of the mix, a device that could actually quantify the balance test by itself, come up with a number that anyone would get, no matter who ran the test. And then we could be more confident that what we had was a good measure.
Okay, Jeff, so I'm going to have you put your hands on your hips, and you're going to look straight ahead and just try to hold your balance.
Goebel developed software that can interface with tablet computers to make the device easier to use on the sidelines. Goebel and his team are collecting balance data from 1,000 people. From that, they'll be able to tell what normal balance looks like without a head injury.
So you could compare somebody after a head injury to that normative database and figure out if they're outside of what normal balance is. But the best way to do it is to get their balance data before the head injury and compare them within themselves pre and post.
So that's exactly what Goebel is doing. He's using B-Trax to measure the balance of SDSU's rugby team before the season starts. There's already a device like B-Trax on the market, but at a cost of nearly $15,000, it's out of the price range of most school and youth sports teams. Goebel wants to sell B-Trax for under $1,000. There are more than 300,000 sports-related concussions each year in the U.S., Scripps Health Dr. Sean Evans says a device that could help reduce the risk of secondary concussions would be terrific.
But there's no substitute for somebody who comes off the field and says, I'm a little dizzy, my head hurts, I don't feel quite right, I've got a little numbness. Or the person who just doesn't look quite right, doesn't respond to their coach, doesn't hear their name well, just doesn't feel quite right to their colleagues. There's no substitute for the insight there in saying, let's get that person out of play.
But what about preventing concussions in the first place? That's hard in rugby, where players don't wear helmets or any other protective gear. Strength coach Oren Cotret says if you want to stay safe, stay home.
There's danger in everything that you do every day. No matter what sport you play, there's always a risk involved, and that's why it's sport.
Kenny Goldberg, KPBS News.